Growing up, I was taught that getting a good education was first and foremost. I started at a community college because it was more affordable and also because I wanted to make sure I had the collegiate skills to perform at a four-year school because my high school resume was C average. Community colleges across the country are a lifeline to young students to continue their education while giving others opportunities to change careers or deepen a love for their favorite hobby. Harford Community College's new president, Dr. Theresa Felder, joins me to talk about the robust curriculum that will include a new $1.5 million workforce development center. Thanks for joining me, Dr. Felder, and welcome to Maryland Perspectives.
Thank you so much, Amelia. It's a pleasure to be with you today. I appreciate the opportunity to talk with you and your listeners.
Well, first of all, congratulations on your new post. Tell us how you found yourself in the rolling hills of Maryland.
How I got here? That's a great question. I am originally from New York. And my parents still live in New York, and I have two siblings in New York. I also have a son that moved to Maryland about 4 years ago after he finished college. He moved to Maryland and started working in D.C. and has a great career going. And I have a brother here. So most all of my family is in the New York, Maryland, Virginia area. And so as I was looking for opportunities, this was the area I focused on, and Harford was meant to be. So I'm happy to be here. It's a beautiful, beautiful area. And like I said, it puts me close to my family. It's a great institution. It's a great part of Maryland, and I'm happy to be here.
Well, you picked a pretty tough time to get started. How are students attending classes this winter, and what does the spring look like in terms of COVID-19 protocol?
Our spring semester looks very similar to our fall semester, and that is most classes are still being held virtually. Unless there's a lab component that requires students to meet, and when that's the case, they are following all the safety protocols to keep both the faculty and the students safe. So they're wearing masks, they're social distancing, and they're only meeting as necessary. As you know, we're very, very hopeful as the vaccines roll out that we'll be able to start ramping back up to more face-to-face. Our students are anxious to be back on campus as well as our staff and faculty.
Your background brings expertise into organizing job training curriculums. Let's start with the additional opportunities inside the cyber program. What types of jobs are they preparing for, and what are some new student options for that program?
We're really excited about some of the new opportunities in our cyber program. As you know, cyber security is an in-demand field, and so there are job opportunities, well-paying job opportunities, both in government and industry. And so we have some accelerated opportunities in both the credit and non-credit programs. Thanks to a grant from the National Science Foundation, we've made some changes to the program so that students can get an associate's degree in 17 months. So that's accelerated. It also gives students an opportunity to start and get into the workforce as quickly as possible. So that's a very exciting opportunity for students.
And that's not the only grant that you've received. Tell us about the Leading Edge Training Center powered by the Ratcliffe Foundation.
We are very, very grateful for a grant that a $1.5 million grant that was received from the Ratcliffe Foundation. Because of that funding, we're able to expand upon the work that we're already doing in the Route 40 corridor with our Harford Community College at Edgewood initiative. So we started that about a year ago, offering classes at the library, the county library, public library, which was a great partnership. But now we're able to expand with this gift from the foundation to work with the Boys and Girls Club to establish Harford's Leading Edge Training Center, powered by the Ratcliffe Foundation. And so with that training center, we're expanding, we're offering programs in the construction trades, manufacturing, warehouse distribution, logistics, some apprenticeships. So it's very exciting. It gives us the opportunity to take much-needed training to that area of the county where there's a great need for workforce development. So this is a game changer for that area, for the students as well as the businesses in that space.
So is there going to be a new building for this? Will it be on the grounds of the college, or will it be at the Boys and Girls Club?
It will be at the Boys and Girls Clubs, but it will include some renovation to expand the space so that we can put in the equipment necessary for these training programs.
When do you think that'll be up and running?
We plan to start this summer. July of this year, we'll start with about 150 students, And the plan is to increase at least by 20% each year and continue to grow.
This year, obviously, with the pandemic, the Maryland government has also stepped up with some monies, including the governor's Emergency Education Relief Program. How will this help students get enrolled into the community college?
This offers additional financial support. So with the $477,000 award from the what we call GEAR funding, as you said, governor's Emergency Education Relief funding, it helps us to provide scholarships that will cover full tuition for many of these in-demand programs, along with stipends for textbooks, software, materials, and supplies. So it really provides much-needed financial assistance for students to take advantage of the time that we're in, where there's a demand for some of these programs, as well as a need for those that are unemployed or underemployed and want to upskill. We're taking full advantage of the assistance from the governor's office and offering these opportunities and hoping that more and more students will take advantage.
So who would be eligible for these scholarships or stipends?
Any student can apply. They can go to our website, www.harford.edu, and find the program and simply fill out an application. And there's more information about the program on the website. If a student can't find any information on the website, and you should be able to, but just in case, I also have a phone number, and that's our admissions office. Someone will answer, and that's at 443-412-2109 if you would like to talk to someone in person. Again, I'm going to repeat that number. It's 443-412-2109.
I opened up by saying how community college prepared me and gave me a leg up in my life, and I also received financial assistance through the federal government. What have you seen over your decades of experience as to how this particular experience at a community college changes lives?
It is my life's work, actually. I didn't talk a lot about my background, but I actually have an undergrad degree in accounting, and I started working as an accountant straight out of college. I later transitioned to my own consulting company, and the community college in my area was one of my clients. And the more I got involved with the college, I saw the difference that community colleges make in the lives of students, and most particularly in students that are underrepresented in higher ed, like first-generation, low-income, minority students that aren't always accessing higher education as they should. Myself being a first-generation college graduate, I was drawn to the community college because there were students just like me who really struggled to get there and needed assistance to stay. And so I made the decision to make a career change. I went back to school, got a master's degree, and then a doctorate degree, and just started working as hard as I could to make a difference in the lives of students, and progressed in my career to the point where I was ready to lead an institution. So for me, I'm passionate about this work because it is meaningful. I see the difference that it makes in students, and not just the student, but their children and then their children. And so for generations, when you have one student that makes the decision to go to college, you'll see the impact that that has on a family. And so that inspires me every day.
Well, you're inspiring as well. What a great story. Thank you so much for sharing that today, Dr. Felder.
Sure.
Where can people go to learn more about the cyber training, spring enrollment, and the Leading Edge Training Center?
All of that information can be found on our website. Again, that's www.harford.edu. or by calling. If you have a preference to talk to someone live, you certainly can at 443-412-2109.
Dr. Theresa Felder is the president of Harford Community College. I'll make sure I get all those links up on our website, 98online.com, and I'll include that phone number as well. Welcome to our great state, and for your years of service as an educator, I'm glad you chose Maryland to make your home, and I wish you every success at the college.
Thank you so much, Amelia. Thank you again for the opportunity to talk about Harford Community College and the opportunity to serve the community, and I look forward to really working for the years to come to make a difference.